scientists in South Africa have begun to advocate for a controversial way to conserve the species.
Active management definitely comes in a situation like South Africa. No animal in South Africa is free roaming anymore. All wildlife is constrained.
In the last century, the conversion of wildlife into wildlife ranching is the biggest success story, which a lot of people don't like to acknowledge that, but it's true. Wildlife ranching took off in Southern Africa. It didn't take off in Kenya. This is why we have these two contrasting stories with giraffes. The giraffes here are still increasing.
The main reason is ownership.
There is a persuasive case to be made that the intensive management of wildlife in Southern Africa does produce results. The situation there, the conditions there are different.
One has to be very careful about applying broad brushstrokes to solving conservation problems in Africa. I think the problem with hunting is that in theory, it's not a bad idea that you can get a lot of money from a single animal that you can put back into conservation. But in practice, it's very different. Greedy people become involved, they want to make the money, and the science can go to hell.
We've sort of got to this point that if we don't see something as an asset, then it has no use to us. I personally don't believe in hunting, but it has protected ecosystems.
In many African countries, people don't derive benefits from the wildlife, where had it been in South Africa, we would have restocked an area, put up a tourist lodge, and turned it into a money-making operation.
From our perspective here in East Africa, we tend not to be quite so meddlesome. We don't play God. Here we have wildlife. There they have game, farming.
I don't think a completely natural system where there's a hands-off management can exist anymore. We have to interfere and we have to make decisions.